I have a big background in information systems development. I started in University of Turku doing empirical research in hospital research project. Then I went to work in the hospital for 6 years in management reporting and data warehousing. Then I came here to Aalto University to usability research, or actually data quality research, but focusing on usability of information. And then about 1 year I have been doing information management consulting in Siili Solutions. So actually, even if I'm now talking a little about my research and research findings, all this research is actually inspired and coming from my old real work from hospital information, and also how what I'm now doing here in Siili. So this is more like a practice-inspired research and practice-inspired findings. So I'm still a doctoral student. I didn't graduate yet. Hopefully dissertation will come soon. Business, and then also I'm activist in this information management and quality control. A lot of activism in social media, and also member of Aalto University steering group, research and innovation. This is my topic, black boxes. Open data is too often black box. And now I'm trying to tell you why I claim this. So first we can start from what information production actually is. There is some people who enter data to some systems. So then some other people start to collect data, transform it, and build all kind of reports. And then somebody will try to figure out what kind of decisions they can make from that data. And technically, there is some kind of data sources. It can be Excel file or database or anything. It's processed, stored, and then it's some kind of report. And this is actually result of my Aalto University Qualidat project. We found out that actually when managers and chief physicians and politicians try to compare hospitals, they try to figure out which one is better hospital and which one is worse. And we audited the whole system, how data is actually collected, how it's going through, and we found out that there's a big problems in human errors. Actually, these hospital benchmarkings are not really valid because of these major errors. There is differences in software systems, how data is transformed, and there can be biases. And also there's obscurity, that people don't understand what's actually going on in this process. So there's errors, and the big problem is that there's doctors and nurses who enter data, and they don't know what's happening here. And then also IT people who collect data, they don't see what's going on here. They don't understand all the details. So they live in their own black box. And then national registry collects data, but they don't actually know how exactly hospitals transform data to their format, and they don't know how exactly doctors and nurses enter the data. And there is a hidden problems in this system. And of course, then somebody tries to make decisions, and people from here don't exactly don't know how their data is transformed to reports and how somebody is trying to compare hospitals. And I have heard that when chief medical officers are in their national meetings and somebody brings some statistics about hospitals, every chief medical officer raises his hand and says, no, you can't use that, it's crap, it's not comparable, it's biased. So this is a common problem. And we have this paper is about this project, so you can read more about it. But this is the real problem. These obscure statistics, they are biased and erroneous. We did an analysis about that. And the real problem, even bigger problem, is we don't know how much there is errors, and we don't know which directions. they are. For example, these biostatistics measure quite a lot volume of administrative documentation. How much you enter diagnosis codes, it affects your rankings. And actually, during our research project, Tampere University Hospital made new data entry coding. They fixed their systems, and actually they got 10% of more productivity in 1 year. So, and then they say that we actually didn't change anything how we operate. We just fixed our systems. We just started to type more data. So our productivity rised, and now they were one of the probably the worst hospital, but now they are one of the best. But it didn't have anything to do with health. They didn't do anything better in healthcare. It didn't change anything about costs. They just did more administrative documentation. And then there's a lot of medical research about diagnosis code errors. It's really typical that there is 5% or even 50% of missing or erroneous diagnosis codes in patient records. And the problem in productivity benchmarking is that these calculations are weighted, multiplied according to these diagnoses. You get much more productivity points if you have a diabetes diagnosis code than something like some easier disease. And this is a problem because these errors can actually be much bigger than real differences between hospitals. And there's doctors and nurses, they say that Tampere and Turku were almost comparable, that they just can't figure out why somebody is getting 3 times more productivity points about same activity. That there is something wrong, and they don't know how calculations are done and what's wrong. And it can't be in real life. There is some differences, and somebody might be better than other one, but it can't be 3 times better, like these productivity points sometimes measure. And this is the result. They are just too ambiguous and erroneous. About a year ago, Aalto published research about Miehikkälä and this SOTE reform. You can save $5 billion or euros a year. Well, they calculated wrong and they had to do the recalculations. But THL had done different calculations. So depending on which calculation you choose at the same year, you can get that the same place is one of the best, average, or the worst. Which one do you believe, and how is it possible? Everybody claims completely opposite things. The worst and best can change, even if the same research group is trying to fix their own problems. And well, Teemu Malmi concluded that it's really difficult to get overall understanding because data just there is no statistical practices, and the data is ambiguous, and it's not standardized in a way that it can be used for calculations. And I'm pretty sure they know how to calculate, but there is something else that's, it's not about the calculations. So what's the real problem exactly? And it starts with click. And what I try to make point, there is this kind of information production process, but there is some kind of clicks how this data was actually created in the real life. It's not enough that you see the data. It's created somehow. And then somebody is trying to figure out decisions, and you have to know exactly what they are trying to do with that report before you can actually validate, is it even possible to make this kind of decisions? And now a detailed description why these matter. This is one anecdotal example of our research. hospital one, hospital B, and they do surgeries, and patient gets through a surgery in 1.5 hours in the other one. Which one is better? Well, patients come to hospital, they go to reservations, they go to surgery room, starts and go back, and then it ends. Sounds easy. It's just end time minus start time. Easy. But the problem is, what exactly are these? What exactly means this, and how this data is created? How this data is created? How this, what it really means? And we checked what this means in qualitative research. Actually, these who did this analysis, they didn't exactly have knowledge what these actually mean. They have just an understanding that this is beginning, this is end, and there is different steps. So what does mean if patient is registered to hospital 8 o'clock, for example? We analyzed meaning, use, who is entering the timestamp, when it is entered, what kind of tool, what kind of environment. And one way of coming to hospital and register is that you are the patient, you do self-registration with your Kela card or some other card. That is quite clear. But that's in Tampere. In Turku, patient comes in, waits, there's queue, and then they get to the secretary who is now available and opens up registration and clicks somebody is registered with EPR, and then it's done in a current unit. But these are completely different things. It's registration, but somebody has been waiting here quite long, and somebody just comes in and gets with card. So you can't compare registrations between two units or two hospitals. And then sometimes they don't come from home. The patient is transferred from hospital unit to another one. Well, if it's done in after midnight at night, actually nurse or secretary is doing registration for new patient and transfers the clock of registration back to yesterday's midnight. And it's done for some kind of financial allocation and all kind of responsibility of care, management stuff. But they just manually change the clock of the registration time. And well, sometimes they don't come from other hospital unit, but they actually come from home. Actually here, they are changed from a hospital unit to another, but at the normal daytime. So at that time, registration timestamp is actually done at the previous unit. So when I'm at Helsinki and I would be changed to Espoo or otherwise, the sending hospital secretary registers and that time when he is supposed to leave is put to the next event registration time. And 1 minute is added. So you change the city in 1 minute, or change the hospital in 1 minute. And actually the registration time is not the registration time of current event, but it's actually the leaving time of the previous event. Systems change, so manually. And then sometimes this is even ambiguous, because sometimes it means that they will leave at that time. For example, this grandmother will leave in 1 hour, or then somebody will come to pick her up in next 2 hours or at this time o'clock. So these are really subjective measurements, and then they are entered to the registration time of next event. Or it can mean that she's actually leaving right now. So when you see an electronic patient record and there is a registration at something clock, it can mean arrival, available service, midnight previous day, will leave, is leaving now, or will be picked up. But how do you know? They all look the same. You can't see the difference if you look at the data. You must understand how this was created and how this was created. And from data, you can't. So there's different clicks, but they all look the same. And you calculate lead times, who is the fastest hospital. It really doesn't make any sense. Even if the data is perfect and looks perfect and it's looks like standardized, it looks comparable, but it's created in a different ways. And that difference is hidden. So if you rely on data, you do really bad decisions if you don't understand these real clicks, how the data is created. And it's not only about timestamps and registration, it's also date stamps, emails, diagnosis codes, customer identities. It's across all industry sectors, across all data types. Similar phenomena is happening. And this is my research results when I analyzed these problems, and I was in MIT last summer. I claim that open data and open up is because they focus on this data layer. They see the database and what's in it. They see how database is defined. They see who entered the data. They see what was the last task, but they don't see anything else. They don't see what's happening behind, how it was actually created. They see the last version of it. And the problem is that when data is created, collected, and recorded to database, these are unknown, and these the meaning and quality of information can change here. And when you see this, you can't really make a clear connection how it was actually created. And when you see data in database, you might not be able to trace back how it was actually, how data was running in the system and what kind of different user interfaces there was. For example, that one case that a secretary is entering registration timestamp, and then the patient is using the Kela card. The data looks same, but you just can't get information that which one was the user interface. Was it the Kela card reader, or was it the electronic patient record? And these are unknown. So even if you have completely open data, open data models, open application interfaces, it's still a black box because you can't see how data is created. And I claim that in the future, all these context factors should be made transparent. And it would be really nice if you had that kind of system like the previous presenter showed, visualization of differences, these words, you could actually visualize this, where the data actually comes from. Trace back different user interfaces, trace back to different source places where the data is coming from. And what this means for open data and openness in general, even if you are open, well, don't be a black box. You should open even more. There's hidden inaccuracies and contextual variations. You have to know if this timestamp was created by patient or nurse or secretary or someone else. And these open data and open up is, it's not enough that you provide the data and data model or application interface. You should also provide the provenance metadata about what's behind data model, what's behind the application interface, how it's really created. So from black box, more transparency, that could help us to get more better quality and understand what the data really is and what kind of decisions you can make out of it. Because if you can't see these, well, your decisions will be biased, wrong, and well, they can have really problematic consequences. Okay, thanks.
Okay, thank you, Sami. So any quick questions for Sami before coffee? Ella, please.
How much will metadata help here?
What?
Oh. Metadata, how much will it solve the problems you showed?
It depends. Information is contextual, and sometimes you need more metadata, sometimes less. And there should be much more. The problem actually with this metadata management is that you can't know beforehand what metadata you need, because the metadata requirements depend on what kind of decisions you will be making. So after you know the question that you want, somebody tries to do, and decision, then you can actually get, hey, actually, if you want to be sure about this, then you should check this metadata. Because sometimes the difference matters, sometimes it doesn't.
Okay, thank you. Maria, just a quick question.
Interoperability, it seems that the data collected from different hospitals, that was not interoperable. There was not interoperability, not enough.
I think currently interoperability means quite a lot technical interoperability and general technical process and workflow, but it doesn't usually cover semantics in enough detailed level, and it definitely doesn't cover pragmatic issues. So there's a difference in pragmatic level and also ambiguity in semantic level.